Hey, Motorman here. And if you just wandered onto this channel by some strange twist of fate, maybe you were looking at plane crashes and somehow I came up on the video, you don't know me. My name is Jerry Palladino. I'm a motor officer instructor. I'm the maker of the Ride Like a Pro video. And often I've got like 1,200 videos on YouTube. I give you a lot of tips and tricks. And I got a question recently about tank slappers. So that's what we're gonna talk about today, tank slappers or head shakes, whatever you wanna call them, and maybe how to get out of them. We're also gonna give you an update on the Triumph Bobber that Triumph was nice enough to loan me for 6 months. So I'm gonna be doing some riding on this motorcycle and mostly around town stuff. So come on, I'm gonna ask you to come along for the ride, but there's no seat on the back. So you're gonna have to be tough to come along. So let's go for a ride. So all right, tank slappers, wobbles, head shakes, there's a lot of names for it. And the first thing I need to tell you, if it happens to you, what you need to do is keep your eyes wide open, because it ain't often you're gonna see a crash like the one you're about to be in. Okay, I'm joking with you. That's a joke. I'm gonna warn you, I will be using humor occasionally. Sometimes I forget to use humor. Sometimes it just comes out, but I'm warning you. So if humor offends you, shut this off right now. But let me tell you first what tends to cause. There's so many causes for a tank slapper or a wobble. That's where the handlebars start going violently left to right, right to left, so much so that it could even be slamming into the tank. And if you get to that point, there's probably nothing you can do, and you're gonna high side off the motorcycle. And I've also heard of the dreaded Harley wobble, and I've seen a video on YouTube where I think it's a police motor officer, they're doing their testing of different motorcycles, and he gets into a wobble. First, the way I found, because it's happened to me not on a Harley but on a Honda 750, how to get out of it is to let off the gas, put your weight forward, don't use the brakes, and slow down until it stops wobbling. That may not work every time. And I've heard that the reason it happened on Harley Davidson's is because the front and rear tire weren't aligned. Now, it happened to me several times, but on a Honda 750, a CB750 back in 1976. That was before I had any training. I didn't know what the hell I was doing. And I would go upstate New York. I was living in the city at the time, but I'd go to upstate New York, 40, 50 miles outside the city. There's some great riding up there. And I would get into a turn, not having any training whatsoever. And I'd realize I was going too fast. I would let off the gas or attempt to brake, and I would do an on and off brake motion, on and off with the gas. And sure enough, the bike would start to wobble. I didn't realize it then, but I was the one causing it by doing stupid things like that. Not using proper technique, not knowing anything about it. So it really wasn't the motorcycle's fault, it was something I was doing. I've also seen it on sport bikes where guys are, it happens a lot, I guess, on sport bikes where they're popping a wheelie at high speeds, and when they come down, the handlebars aren't pointed straight ahead, so the tire is pointed slightly to one side or the other, and that throws off the weight distribution and starts a wobble. There's a famous video also on YouTube with a guy on a Harley, I'm not sure which model it is, and he's riding down the highway. And suddenly he's sitting way back, leaning against he's got a big bag on his sissy bar. And it was, I'm not sure which model it was, the chopper-like Harley. And he's leaning way back. And all of a sudden, the shake starts wobbling back and forth. Now it looked like to me that he had thrown off the weight distribution so bad that there wasn't much weight on the front end. When he's got all that weight in the back, plus he's leaning back, goes over a bump, front tire comes up just a little bit. It doesn't have to leave the ground, But when it comes back down, if it's not pointed straight ahead, yeah, you're gonna get a wobble or a head shake. I've watched several videos on YouTube, but Grand Prix type racing, it happens as well. And it's usually when they get into a turn and there's a dip in the ground and the front wheel comes up just a little bit after the dip. And again, when it comes back down, it starts to shake. Very scary. Pretty easy thing to avoid if you just use a little common sense. Go into your turn slow, come out rolling on the throttle. You could use a little front brake to the apex of the turn and then release the front brake. That'll help plant your front tire, give you more traction. I've never found that. I'd use that unless coming down a winding mountain road where engine braking isn't enough. So you use a little bit of front brake. When you're in the turn, as you get to the apex, you want to release that brake. So most of the time, I would say it's caused by rider error. But the only way I found, at least it helped in my situation, and I did it out of dumb luck. I didn't know what I was doing, but I knew something was wrong as those handlebars started to shake back and forth. And I was only going probably 40, 45, 50 miles an hour around some pretty severe curves at the time. And I found out that if I just let off the gas easily, put a little weight on the front tire, it would come out of it. Oftentimes it would go back into it when I went around a curve and got on and off the throttle and on and off the brake. And that would cause it again. I was always thinking that's just the way these bikes were back in the 70s, but no, it was my fault. I know better than to do that now. By the way, it's a very windy day here in Florida, and I'm on this bobber with this little tiny deflector windshield. It blocks, I put this on because it does block some of the wind coming to your chest. It seems like, yeah, the wind is probably right about here. Now, I'm not getting any helmet buffeting, so it's working very well. And I don't think it looks bad. This, by the way, is from National Cycle. I got this type here with these horseshoe clamps. I don't recommend them. The other clamps they offer, though, are quite a bit bigger. And I didn't think there was enough room on the handlebars to put those type of clamps on. But overall, a little tedious to put this on and get it adjusted. But it does work. So for, I think it was like $130. I don't think it's worth that much money, but that's what it cost. And it does do the job. So we've discussed the tank slappers and wobbles, why that happened, how I recommend you get out of it. And we'll talk a little bit about this motorcycle, this test bike that I'm gonna have for, I guess, about 6 months. Anything I add to it, I have to do with at my own expense. So you can bet that I'm only gonna add something that I absolutely need. And I'll tell you a little bit about the bike. It is a very fun motorcycle to ride. It pegs the fun meter. The meter goes to 10, this is about a 9. It's got plenty of power, very smooth. I compared it, a week or two ago with the Sportster 48, also a bobber type motorcycle. Plus I've got a Sportster sitting in the garage, so I can easily go from one bike to another for comparison's sake. And this is a more fun bike to ride. It feels much lighter in the turns, and that's probably because it's got a steeper rake, because the weight difference is maybe this is about 25 pounds lighter. Shouldn't even feel that, but because it's got a steeper rake, it feels extremely nimble. But overall, I'm enjoying the bike. It's fun to ride. Extremely nimble, handles very well, got plenty of power, 77 horsepower, 78 foot-pounds of torque, and on a 525 pound bike, I mean, it's not a sport bike, but it's quick. All right, till next time, this is Motorman signing out.